Yeah, the Dallas Police Department tweeted asking anyone if they had videos of illegal activity from the protests to send it to their iWatch Dallas app, right? So this K-pop stan account posted this tweet, basically telling everyone to download that Dallas app and send them their fan cams. Basically, fan cams are video edits of their favorite K-pop star. And they told them to flood the app. And not long after, they tweeted that their app is down due to technical difficulties. And that, my friends, is called strategy.
When we see comments on our TikTok like, why is a black woman with a white man, or why is a white man with a black woman?
For God's sake, he's pink.
Hey, stop scrolling. I have something to tell you. You need to treat yourself like your best friend, period. You gas up your best friend? When was the last time you gassed yourself up? You forgive your best friend? When was the last time you forgave yourself? You take care of your best friend? When was the last time you truly took care of yourself? You love your best friend unconditionally? When did you last love yourself unconditionally? Do it today. You are your best friend. Period.
Every day at 4:20 p.m., I remind myself of the life I used to live when I had my own college apartment. But now that I have moved back in with my parents, my 4:20 p.m.s are not the same.
If you don't get the point, you? Yeah, you are on native land. If you are standing on Turtle Island, you are on native land. Land.
I'm coming home, tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday.
And if you're gonna call me Maria, make sure to put Carly in front of it, Karen.
So yesterday, some white people decided to make fun of the Blackout Tuesday and did a Whiteout Tuesday hashtag. So the K-pop stans flooded the hashtags with some fan cams again. Again, that is called strategy.
I am tired of this narrative that body positivity promotes obesity, that self-love promotes an unhealthy lifestyle. No, me telling you to love yourself in this moment is only for your gain. What do you gain by hating yourself? What changes if you hate your reflection in the mirror? How does the world become better that way? It doesn't. All we have is this moment. This is the only moment that we are guaranteed. So are we going to spend it hating ourselves or loving ourselves?
Hello.
Oh, damn. You're hot.
Okay. Here we go.
Hey, what's up, baby? You want my jalebi? Don't say maybe.
Oh,
Hell no. White privilege doesn't exist. What about all the white people that are homeless?
Would you like to do something about the homeless
No.
All right.
Hey guys, I'm gonna show you how I twist my boyfriend's hair. He does have a dry, itchy scalp, so I do put coconut oil and exfoliate his scalp before starting. I make sure that his hair is washed before I twist, and you're gonna need these products. And to start off, I'm gonna do a middle part all the way down, and then I'm also gonna do it across. She'll look a little something like this. Alright, so I like to work front to back. I'm going to start off with this side, and then I'm going to section his hair off evenly. Spray some water, brush it out, and add both products in. And then I'm going to go ahead and twist. And I also really make sure to take my time on parting his hair just so that it can look as neat as possible. And to show you guys again, I'm just twisting his hair. It's getting pretty late, so I'm going to wrap this up. It's about 3 a.m. Finally done. Let's see his reaction.
I've gotten a few comments like this recently, and let me tell you, I used to get into arguments about this word with one of my ex-boyfriends all the time, so let's talk about the word Latinx. As we've all seen before, the word Latinx is supposed to be a gender-neutral version of the word Latino. Spanish is a gendered language, everything is either masculine or feminine, and people who are outside of the gender binary wanted a term to describe their ethnic group that also included them. In the past, people have tried the O slash A or the arroba, but, you know, neither of those really worked and they were kind of clunky, and hence the term Latinx ended up becoming popular. But hence, the word is not perfect, and obviously there has been a lot of criticism about it. People often see the word Latinx as an anglicization of the word Latino and hence taking the word away from its Spanish roots. And that concern is completely valid. We don't want to be further assimilated into Anglo-American culture. But here's the thing, it's really hard to have a word that is truly inclusive in a language that is so exclusionary. Reminder that Spanish is also a colonizer language, and the gender binary was heavily reinforced by the Spanish upon indigenous people. For the time being, a lot of people who don't fit into the gender binary see the word Latinx as something that works for them. But language changes constantly. In a few years, we might have a word that's more inclusive for everybody and also works with Spanish.
I didn't get enough of you. Step one to get the perfect bikini body is to find a bikini. Step two is to put it on. Step three is to not give a crap about what anyone has to say about you and your beautiful bikini, because your body is gorgeous. You're going to wear what you want and you're going to look amazing. Done.
Youth of color have really been hit hard with the recent events, especially as they're already missing events important to them, such as dances, concerts, and graduations. POC TikTok! More like a crash course in ethnic studies! You're scared of losing friends just where Black Lives Matter. I'm scared of losing friends just where COVID-19 trauma. You and I are not the same! Do mixed trans boys name themselves Jaden? If your name is Jaden, you're either mixed or trans. If you're gonna call me Maria, make sure to put Carly in front of it. Why does Karen always call my middle name, but not my first? Instead of focusing on a safe return back to campus, schools should focus on how to improve online classes for the fall. If you're the only person of color in the friend group, don't let them tokenize you. Minorities can't be erased. Tonight would have been my first concert. Instead, I was forced to become an educator overnight just so my black friends could make it to my 20th birthday. What if I protest signs that anti-racist since conception? Yes, I really was.
And this is why we find white guys attractive. They look like tortillas.
Something I may try. This drink doesn't taste right. It wasn't like our drunk nights. It wasn't like our drunk nights. It wasn't like our drunk nights. We haven't talked in months. For justice and fun. I barely even eat anymore.
Time for a little late night language. Y'all know this symbol? You know what it's called? If you said the and sign, I get it, but some of you smarticle particles out there might have said the ampersand. But where did the ampersand come from, and where did it get its name? Well, there are two important elements to recognize about the ampersand, its shape and its name. So we'll start with the shape. The shape that we recognize today as the and sign, or the ampersand, actually derives from the Latin word et, which is just and. It was spelled E-T, and as you can see, it gradually, the E-T kind of got mushed together into one little symbol. And this was actually treated like a 27th letter of the alphabet. It was put at the end of the alphabet, and it was called et, and then later, and. So when people were reciting the alphabet, they would recite the and at the end of the alphabet, and they would use the phrase per se, which is a Latin phrase meaning by itself. So they would end the alphabet with XYZ and per se, and. And eventually that got all slurred together to ampersand.
Notice how healthcare workers, like especially those who work in the emergency room, they restrain dangerous people all the time, like people who are intoxicated, people in different mental states, like people who are confused. They're able to restrain them without crushing their windpipe or using any lethal force. But the police can't.
Hi, I'm so happy you're here. I wanted to share some pockets of peace from my day. Because I believe that each day carries a few moments of goodness, and we deserve to enjoy them. Today, I felt like getting dressed up, just because. No special reason, just being alive. Seth and I went to a doctor's appointment, and I continued with meetings and work for the rest of the afternoon. I prepared Bengali-style barbecue for an early dinner, and ended my day with some of my favorite things. I am so excited for this next chapter together, and I hope you find your pockets of peace in your life. Because you deserve it. How was your day?
Okay, so I look like this. That's me. And God had the audacity of making my best friend look like this. God, you playing games. You picking favorites. You playing games. Turn me on till early morning, let's get it.
so good, just turn it.